Can I talk to you, ma'am? Do you live here? It's just my audience is watching and is outraged.
We need help. Our apartments are falling apart. NYCHA is not doing anything to help us. You understand what I'm saying? They're just taking our rent money and not fixing our apartments up. And I think it's a damn shame. Okay?
You know, it's incredible because a lot of people that would be watching, if the gas was out in their apartments, you know, maybe a few days... If that,
this is not the first time this has gone on. Last year, year before last, we had no gas for almost 6 or 7 months. They gave us hot plates.
6 or 7 months?
6 or 7 months, year before last. They gave us hot plates to use. That's how long the gas was out.
And they made you pay rent.
And we had to still pay our rent on time. Like now, even with the corona, we still have to pay our rent. But they're not doing anything to fix up the apartments. I live on the 6th floor, and being that they just put those, what do you call it, generators up there, I have structural damage, and my apartment is literally crumbling around me. So what are we to do?
And let me ask you, just day to day, how are you providing your meals? Can you make meals on those hot plates that they provided you?
Are you kidding me? One at a time. One at a time. A meal we take, we have to use the hot plate to make a full dinner. You have to use it one at a time. If I want to make a piece of meat, I have to do the meat. If I want to make rice or vegetables, I have to wait to do them one at a time. And it doesn't make any sense. If you all can help us, I'd really would appreciate it. And God bless you.
What's your name again?
My name is Ray Harris.
Ray Harris? Thank you. Appreciate it. It's something. It's really something. And she just described it. I mean, it's like, think in Flint, for example, the things you would never even think about. They gotta brush their teeth with bottled waters. I've spoken with people in Flint that to take a bath, they gotta pour in 150 bottles of bottled water. Here, if you want to do meat, you got to do like one at a time on a hot plate. That's my wife, if she's watching, she knows I don't really cook, but I could only imagine that could take a very long time, a very long time. And who has that time? If you got kids, that's an all day job. If you're elderly, maybe you have more time, but it's more cumbersome for you to have to do that. We've heard from people, human rights. It's inhumane. It's inhumane. And you grew up in Brooklyn, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Would this kind of thing happen where you grew up too for 30, 60 days?
I think it's certain parts, definitely, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Especially with the NYCHA houses, they're just really, the past couple of years, they've been falling apart and you know, there's been some issues with them.
They've been falling apart as New York City under Bloomberg, under de Blasio, have let the rich take over the kingdom.
Pretty much, yep.
Yeah, and that's another thing. I mean, yeah, this is local New York City, but if you want to nationalize it, the same story nationally. You have progressive mayors, Democratic governors, so we got de Blasio, Cuomo. You know, they put out nice platitudes. You know, Cuomo during his day to every single day, those must-see TV press conferences that CNN had him doing. They made him the resistance hero during the pandemic. Well, by the way, he killed 6,000 people in nursing homes. Let's not go into that. His brother, Christopher Cuomo, brought him on CNN primetime to, like, joke around and put something up his nose. It was ridiculous. But they get it right in terms of the progressive language. They get it right in terms of the progressive symbolism, you know? Bill de Blasio, when he was running, did a commercial with his black son to try and say, hey, I get your plight. I have a black son, I have a black wife, this and that. But then he's let the police just continue the militarized execution of black people all over New York City. And now, you know, so we have so-called progressives in governance, but they're handing out the city to real estate developers. That's why when I go down the list of money we don't take, no money from the bankers, no money from the fossil, no money from big pharma. I also say big real estate, because big real estate, let me tell you something, the Democrats take money hand over fist. All of these cities, New York City, Seattle, Portland, San Francisco, Los Angeles, Chicago, Washington, D.C., Philadelphia, Cleveland, and on and on and on and on. Raise your hand in your community. The local officials and the governors are selling out public housing, are selling out low-income housing, and they are giving, they're literally, in some cases, paying developers. I give you a prime example. The resistance hero, Pete Buttigieg, how they said he brought back South Bend. You know what he brought back? Four blocks in South Bend. He literally, the South Bend government paid businesses in Chicago, which is, I think, an hour and a half away from South Bend, Indiana, paid luxury companies, hotels, this and that, to come to South Bend. So paying for, you know, wealthy, luxury companies. I remember when I was in South Bend, they had a luxury hotel there. Paying them to come to South Bend, you beautify four or five blocks. They put, like, I think they spent $25 million or something like that to have a light show over the river, to have lights over the river downtown as some attraction. And meanwhile, outside of that downtown perimeter, left the city to rot.
Hope you enjoyed that last video. Hop on over to statuscoup.com where you can sign up for our email list and become a member for as low as $5 to $10 a month. Membership is how we grow. That's statuscoup.com/join. And remember, join our email list so we can grow the revolution with you.